Welcome to Alliance Military
Database. Why not? Let's play this for a bit.
Classified information requested. Establishing secure connection. Secure connection confirmed. Please log in to access your profile. Profile reconstruction complete. Please log in to access your profile. Please log in to access your profile reconstruction complete.
Dang it, I forget.
Please log in to access your profile. Please log in to access your profile.
All right, go custom, not quick start.
Warning, data corruption detected. Please reconstruct profile.
Sure
confirm
thing.
Confirm pre-service history.
I'll go with Earthborn, because why not?
Psychological profile.
Been a while since I played this, so yeah, why not? Soul
confirm
Survivor sounds
military
good.
Military specialization.
Is there really any other option? Yes.
Confirm facial identification. Profile reconstruction complete.
There we go, that's what I want.
Identification confirmed.
New veteran. I'm not really hardcore on insanities. Ugh. Squad only, auto level up, that's fine. Keep it on normal, I might change it later, I'm not sure. Alrighty then, this will work.
Well, what about Shepard? Earthborn, but no record of his family.
Doesn't have one. He was raised on the streets, learned to look out for himself. He saw his whole unit die on a cruise. He could have some serious emotional scars.
Every soldier has scars. Shepard's a survivor.
Is that the kind of person we want protecting the galaxy?
That's the only kind of person who can protect the galaxy.
I'll make the call.
Hitting the relay in Thrusters? Check. Navigation? Check. Internal emission sync engaged. All systems online. Drift? Just under 1500K.
1500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
You always expect the worst.
Now, bad feelings are an occupational hazard. But we don't go anywhere unless there's a good reason, so... what are we doing here?
Joker! Status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
He sounds angry. Something must have gone wrong with the mission.
Captain always sounds like that when he's talking to me.
Can't possibly imagine why.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the Captain?
I'm on my way to give him a status update right now.
With all due respect, sir, maybe he'll finally tell you what we're really doing out here.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not the kind of place Spectres visit. There's something Nihlus isn't telling us about this mission.
That's crazy. The Captain's in charge here. He wouldn't take orders from a Spectre.
Not his choice, Doc. Spectres don't answer to anyone. They can do whatever they want. Kill anyone who gets in their way.
Oh, you watch too many spy vids, Jenkins.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool, even under fire.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself on a coup. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you. Don't do something stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, sir. I'm not gonna screw this up.
The Captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander.
Let's do Paragon. Try to go for Paragon for sure, because that's what I do.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
Is someone gonna fill me in, Captain?
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, It jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why didn't we keep the beacon for ourselves?
You humans don't have the best reputation. Some species see you as selfish, too unpredictable, too independent, even dangerous.
Sharing that beacon will improve relations with the Council. Plus, we need their scientific expertise. They know more about the Protheans than we do.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
What's going on, Captain?
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
Not many could have survived what you went through on Akuz. You showed a remarkable will to live, a particularly useful talent. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Get down!
We are under attack, taking heavy casualties! I repeat, heavy casualties! We can't stop there! Get evac! They came out of nowhere! We need...
out after that. No comm traffic at all. Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5. Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihlus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihlus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
We are approaching drop point two.
So we got the regular map now. Okay, I can bring it up with the M. Cool. Okay. Having me face one direction on the map, that's kind of weird, but whatever. Oopsie. There's no reloading. Huh. I need to unlock sniper rifles. Do. Oh, I left that grenade there. That's why. I'm dumb.
Rip right through his shields. We're out of chance.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, sir.
Okay, that's how I bring up the menu. Oh wait, that's pull this out. I'll eventually get trained in this. I'm going backwards, aren't I? Nope.
I smell trouble.
Okay, yeah, just stick to the pistol for now.
Got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. Lot of bodies.
First aid kits on there, but I can't remember how right now. Be handy for later on for sure. That ain't right.
I've lost shield.
Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, sir?
Are you wounded, Williams?
A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, sir. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, sir. It's time for payback.
Move out.
More like assault rifle. I'm not using assault rifles right now. It might be wise to give it to her. Oh, is the compass actually working correctly now? Looks like it. Or maybe not. I think it might be a little busted still, or I'm going the wrong way and I'll find that. Yeah, it's still broken. Cool. First aid is F. Might want to do that. With the sniper rifle on lock.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Invisible Ashley.
Huh. Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
I'm not sure I do that. That's more damage. It's not, I'd kind of rely on accuracy a bit. Okay, hammer one again. Not very accurate, so I'll stick with what I got. I wanna go this way, I don't think, yeah, let's need to go this way. Well, the map was actually helping me because it's currently not.
really hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up. Oh, God. They're still alive.
What did the Geth do to them?
Overheated.
Negative contacts, Commander.
Nothing else in here. Oh yes, this thing.
Humans, thank the Maker.
Hurry, close the door before they come back.
Don't worry, we'll protect you.
Thank you, I think we'll be okay now. It looks like everyone's gone. You're Dr. Warren, the one in charge of the excavation. Do you know what happened to the beacon? It was moved to the spaceport this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to help pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment. The next we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the Destroyers, bringers of darkness, heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside, gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
Did you notice a Turian in the area?
I saw him, the Prophet, leader of the enemy. He was here before the attack.
That's impossible. Nihlus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry. Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in.
Poor guy. Alright. Okay, that leads back, so we don't want to do that. Okay, so I'm not really going north.
Saren. Nihlus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
Well, rip him. want that for sure. Combat in this game kind of sucking.
Stay calm out there. We're coming out. We're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the shed. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. I knew it was trouble the second I saw it, so we made a break for the sheds.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
Do you know anything about the Protean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only it was coming from inside your own head.
It was probably trying to block communications.
Whatever it was, it felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to think.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
You're breaking the law, Cole.
We're not hurting anybody. Hell, most of the time I don't even know what's in the packages. Just thought there might be something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. Probably get more use out of it than we will.
This should help. Let's move out.
Good luck.
I'll take a look at this in a moment. I'll take more stuff. Let's see. Avenger, okay, so they're all hammer. What? Not gonna help me much. Okay, I'm mostly using pistol. He's got pretty much the biotics pistol, basically. Check the pistol. She's soldier, I believe, so. Yeah, soldier. Pistols and assault rifles mainly have her use the assault rifle.
Commander. It's Nihilus.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait! Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I'm sorry, I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
I need to know how Nihilus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was in trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
Of course.
You survived because you're lazy?
If you hadn't snuck off for that nap, you'd probably be dead just like all the others.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I don't really want to think about it.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. 1 minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Oh, yep, run through fire. Oh, yep, okay. That was dumb of me. I thought I'd be out of the fire, but apparently not. There we go, that's a safe way of grabbing it. Okay, that's perfect. Thank you. Definitely get sniper rifles up. Using the sniper rifle again. Kind of run a little bit. Remember this next part really sucking, probably because of the time that makes it tricky.
Set the charges, destroy the entire colony, leave no evidence that we were here.
Demolition charges. The Geth must have planted them.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
Dead. Can't save while I'm in combat. That. Huh. Don't actually need to do that because I killed everything from far away. There we go, that's actually pretty easier than I make it out to be before. And done.
Think we got him, Commander.
Reaper 2. A little bit too less accuracy than I'm wanting, though. Accuracy's important. Definitely get that, though. Basic rounds and high caliber barrel. And more money and experience, because that's always good. Make sure there's something on the other side as well. Oh, there's a storage locker over here I still get to. Get all the good stuff. Side has nothing. It shuts aside with nothing.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Sucked into the beacon.
Shepard!
No, don't touch it! It's too dangerous!
And now it's destroyed. Lovely.
Identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
Doctor! Dr. Chakwas! I think he's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
How did I end up here? How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death? Destruction? Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the commander's going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Chief Williams isn't part of the Normandy crew.
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Yep.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren. That other Turian. Saren's a specter. One of the best. A living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how. I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we gonna tell him? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation is politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
We prove Saren's gone rogue, and the Council will revoke his specter status.
I'll contact the Ambassador, and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Thanks, Commander. I appreciate that.
Things were pretty rough down there. Are you okay?
I've seen friends die before. Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit wiped out. And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't shown up.
We couldn't have done it without you, Williams.
Thanks, Commander. I have to admit, I was a little worried about being assigned to the Normandy. It's nice when someone makes you feel welcome.
I think you're gonna fit in here just fine, Williams.
Thanks, Commander.
Alrighty.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work. Size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower, too.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower.
Tower, please proceed to Dock 422.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of the Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Lovely.
Captain Anderson. I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime. In case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. He needs to be stopped. The Council has to listen to us.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not his.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
I think the compass is working here, so why not?
sincere apology, but I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
You seem distressed. Is there something I can do to help?
Alarmed response. You overheard that, did you? This is all going so wrong, and it is the Asari consort's fault. She's the one who started all this.
What did this Asari do to get you so upset?
I cannot speak more about this problem. It is too sensitive. Suffice it to say, she has compromised my authority as a diplomat.
Where can I find this Asari consort?
She is across the bridge from here. Her offices are easy enough to spot. Good day, human.
This guy's a little weird, but okay, why not?
Greetings, and welcome to the Presidium. My name is Avena, and I am pleased to be your virtual guide throughout this level of the Citadel Space Station.
So are you a person or a program?
I am a fully interactive virtual intelligence, programmed to provide spontaneous guidance at predetermined locations of interest throughout this level of the Citadel. I may also be contacted through any of the Presidium VI terminals, should you require assistance.
Give me the tour.
You are standing at Presidium Tourism Terminal 1. On either side of this lobby are the embassies of the various Citadel races, along with CSEC headquarters. On the far end of this level, you can see the Citadel Tower, where the Council meets regularly to discuss matters of interstellar importance.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, and thank you for using Avena. Please enjoy your visit to the Citadel.
Who uses rapid transport? It's fun to walk around and explore slowly. Never really actually enjoy doing that. I know it's weird. But we came back here a lot anyway, so why not? So I don't go there yet.
Look at that bug thing over there. What's it doing?
Please do not disturb the keepers.
Alrighty then, we're not disturbing the keepers. Elevator rides. They're all over the place.
The Council isn't going to ask me any questions, are they?
I doubt it. We've made our reports. Now we just have to trust Ambassador Udina.
No, we don't, sir.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the Council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. But he's a specter. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
Yep.
Hmm.
may be right. Will the Hanar need to lighten up a bit first?
You just don't like them because you have trouble understanding them.
Okay. Then we can talk to him later for a quest or something.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard. The one who let the beacon get destroyed.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihlus gone, his files passed on to me. I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
Saren's hiding behind his position as a Spectre. You need to open your eyes.
What we need is evidence. So far, we've seen nothing.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
He'll get what's coming to him eventually.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like, and he has to be stopped.
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's den.
It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial district. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Barla Vaughn's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
I should go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the ambassador's office if you need anything else.
Alrighty, so... Oh, what's she doing?
That guy's up to something.
What? Oh, no, I wasn't. Never mind. Yes, is there something you want?
Why are you so interested in the Keepers?
Keepers? I've got no interest in the Keep...
Don't get coy. I know what I saw.
I'm not so sure I should be talking to you about this.
We're just talking. Is there something wrong with that?
No. I guess it wouldn't hurt to tell you. I'm using a small scanner to gather readings on the Keepers. So far I've had mixed results. I find it difficult to get near the creatures.
Why were you being so secretive about it, though?
Well, technically we're not supposed to disturb the Keepers. I don't really think my scanning disturbs them, but the authorities might disagree. I'd like to do it more openly, but it's not really worth getting arrested over.
I could help you out. I'm not worried about the authorities.
I don't even know who you are.
I'm Commander Shepard, with the Alliance military.
Well, I suppose I could use the help. You'll need this. It's the scanning device I developed. Activate it each time you see a Keeper. All collected data will automatically upload to my database. I'll even send a few credits your way for each unique scan.
I should get going, then.
Yes, I have much work myself. So long, and good luck with the scanning.
Extra money and experience, for sure.
No, I just want to ask a couple of questions.
Commander?
Yeah, I don't really do anything with them yet, still. Let us just go onwards. Not really running any faster. And back down again. Oh, no, the Keeper's scan. Lovely.
To listen to reason. Why can't it act in an orderly and lawful manner?
You should be more tolerant. It's just trying to express its beliefs.
I am not unreasonable. The Hanar is free to spew its nonsense once it purchases an evangelical permit.
If you'd like, I could talk to the Hanar for you.
I have argued with the stubborn jelly all afternoon. You are certainly welcome to try.
Do you desire to learn of the Enkindlers? Or has the Honorable CSEC officer enlisted assistance?
Why is the CSEC officer harassing you?
the CSEC officer request that this one purchase an evangelical permit to spread the truth of the Enkindlers.
Let me talk to the CSEC officer. Perhaps I can explain the situation.
This one would be most grateful for the assistance.
Any progress with that Hanar?
I think you should let the Hanar preach in the Presidium.
The Presidium is a place of culture and respect. It should not be filled with zealots shouting their idiocy. Why should the jellies get special treatment? Every other species understands and obeys the laws.
I'll be back.
I don't care what you have to do. Just get rid of that Hanar.
I need my charm up again. Well, on this playthrough at least. Thank you. Another one.
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
Lots of talking. Oh, yeah, this is like a gateway area.
Do you really think we'll find him down here?
He always stops in for a few games of Quasar before he makes his drop.
Fist is gonna be pissed if we take down his supplier.
That's the point. We want him angry. Angry people make mistakes.
There's just something about Fist that makes me nervous.
That's another one. Gotta find them all, and there's a lot, and I usually have trouble finding like one or two more. Alright, more elevators, because we can't have enough of those.
A Solarian excavation team has run into an unexpected problem after unearthing a Prothean dig site. Hanar protesters have blockaded the dig site, claiming that artifacts of the Enkindlers, as the Hanar call them, should not be disturbed. The excavation team has appealed to Hanar representatives on the Citadel to reach a diplomatic solution.
This area. I have to do that in hopes that I'm actually going a little faster, but I'm probably not.
Hello there, Commander. I'm Dr. Claude Michel. Is there something I can do for you?
Let me take a look at what you have for sale.
Of course.
Might get one of these because I do like having one of these attached. I'm gonna get the one interface for now. Another keeper down. And some codex for more experience. Getting close to next level as well. Need more combat. Combat for experience.
Commander Shepard? Excuse me, Commander Shepard!
I'm Emily Wong. I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't go. I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
Sounds like a good cause. If I find any information, it's yours.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
I find it weird how people walk away. The way they turn their head and walk that direction. It's just kind of weird and awkward looking. Afford buying stuff for now, save my money.
Is that really? Wow, it's you.
You're Commander
Shepard. Oh God, Shepard, it's this guy.
The hero of Eden Prime. I am so honored to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And you are?
My name is Conrad. Conrad Werner. They say you killed more than 100 Geth on Eden Prime.
I spend most of the time trying to stay alive and help the colonists.
Hey, I know you're probably busy, but do you have time for a quick autograph?
Anything for a fan. Here.
Thanks. I really appreciate it. My wife is going to be so impressed. I'll let you get back to work. Oh, but next time you're on Earth, I'd love to buy you a drink. Thanks again!
He is a weird one. Very weird one. Certainly won't bump into him again now, will we? Yeah, we will.
That's him.
Oh, that's not what I meant to click. Expecting that.
Think we're good, Commander.
I'm just gonna boost charm all the way up for now because I kinda need that.
C-Sec officer named Garrus.
Garrus? You must be one of Captain Anderson's crew. Poor bastard, still trying to bring Saren down, eh? I know know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Is there something I should know about the captain?
The captain used to be a specter. Didn't know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush. The first human ever given that honor, and then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
Why'd they kick him out?
Have to ask him. I never heard any of the details. Bet it's a good story, though. The heroes fall. Classic tragedy.
You said they covered all this up. How'd you hear about it?
I spent 20 years working cases here on the Citadel. People on this station love to talk. Secrets are like herpes. If you got them, you might as well spread them around.
Just tell me where Garrus went.
Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office. She runs the med clinic on the other side of the wards. Last I heard, he was going back there.
How well do you know Captain Anderson?
Met him a few times over the years. One of those hardcore military guys. Yes, sir. No, sir. Can't have any fun with a stick up your ass, sir. That's probably why he climbed the Alliance ranks so fast. The military loves brown nosers.
The captain's a good soldier.
Sure, whatever. Dress him in a fancy suit, pin some shiny medals on his chest, and call him a hero. Everybody else does. But if he's so great, why'd the Spectres kick him out? Why'd you go ask him about that?
You need to look in a mirror. Sober up and take some responsibility for yourself.
Save your sermons. This ain't no church.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, good. Go.
Yep, he sure is something. And I'm stuck at this place.
Maybe it's not true. Harkin's an ass. I bet he's just messing with our heads.
You're probably right. Still, I'd like to...
And cut off just like that. I think this is a shortcut path. Or at least it skips the shops. Oh, there's a keeper here. Yeah, because this was back to the elevator.
I didn't tell anyone, I swear!
That was smart, Doc. Now if Garrus comes around, you stay smart. Keep your mouth shut or we'll... Who are you? Let her go.
Engaging target.
Poison those ass hats. I keep doing that. Hiding.
Think we got him, Commander.
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard. What were you thinking? You could have hit the hostage.
There wasn't time to think. I just reacted. I didn't mean to... Dr. Michelle, are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Thanks to you. All of you.
I know those men threatened you. But if you tell us who they work for, we can protect you.
They work for Feast. They wanted to shut me up, keep me from telling Garrus about the Quarian.
What Quarian?
A few days ago, a Quarian came by my office. She'd been shot, but she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run.
She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information in exchange for a safe place to hide.
Where is she now?
I put her in contact with Fist. He's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
Not anymore. Now he works for Saren. And the Shadow Broker isn't too happy about it.
Fist betrayed the Shadow Broker? That's stupid even for him. Saren must have made him quite the offer.
That Quarian must have something Saren wants. Something worth crossing the Shadow Broker to get.
What else can you tell me about the Quarian?
I'm not sure. Like I said, she wanted to trade information for a place to hide. She didn't... Wait a minute. Geth. Her information had something to do with the Geth.
She must be able to link Saren to the Geth. There is no way the Council can ignore this.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
You're a Turian. Why do you want to bring him down?
I couldn't find the proof I needed in my investigation, but I knew what was really going on. Saren is a traitor to the Council and a disgrace to my people.
Welcome aboard, Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take him out.
Yeah, we saw him in the bar.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
What's he doing there?
Fist accused him of making threats. We brought Rex in for a little talk. If you hurry, you can catch him at the Academy before he leaves.
Move out.
I will take you and you. Okay, bit of a bounce there. Punish Metagel. I don't really need Metagel, but I replenish it anyways, because why not? Okay, let's see. Experience this time.
Helix has settled out of court with a Krogan group that had accused the Genetics Corporation of fraud. The Krogan group had contracted Binary Helix to perform studies with a long-range goal of curing their genetic sterilization. The group later sued for a return of investment money when the study produced no viable results.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Rex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
Go on. Get out of here.
Do I know you, human?
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you. We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you a fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying. Seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
Glad to have you on the team, Rex.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
Oh, those two now. Alright, so I'm gonna go back to the den. Which I think the easiest way is not that one. Actually, no, well, back the way I came, I believe. Yeah.
So how about it, Garrus? Is this better than C-Sec?
Fighting a rogue specter with countless lives at stake and no regulations to get in the way? I'd say that beats C-Sec.
There may just be hope for you yet, Turian.
Damn, it's getting late already. I'll stop soon. I need to go down. Let's go this way. It's like combat. Sign me up. Make a quick save, because why not? Yeah, I can't make quick saves when you're in combat scenarios. I'll pull this out, because I have a feeling I'm gonna need it.
Looks like it's shut down.
This knows
what. Look out!
Level up. Only 2 points. Let's get assassination. Unlocks first aid, is it? No, it's not pistols. Get damping soon though. Oh, it's in decryptions where first aid is.
Area secure. Stop right there. Don't come any closer. Warehouse workers. All the real guards must be dead.
Stay back, or we'll shoot.
This would be a good time to find somewhere else to work.
Yeah, right. That's a good idea.
Yeah, I never liked Fist anyway. It would have been quicker to just kill them.
Shooting people isn't always the answer.
Hmm.
is everywhere!
Where's the Quarian?
She's not here. I don't know where she is. That's the truth.
He's no use to you now. Let me kill him.
Wait, wait. I don't know where the Quarian is, but I know where you can find her. The Quarian isn't here. Said she'd only deal with the Shadow Broker himself.
Face to face? Impossible. Even I was hired through an agent.
Nobody meets the Shadow Broker. Ever. Even I don't know his true identity. But she didn't know that. I told her I'd set a meeting up. But when she shows up, it'll be Saren's men waiting for her.
Give me the location. Now.
Here on the wards, the back alley by the markets. She's supposed to meet them right now. You can make it if you hurry. What are you doing?
The Shadow Broker paid me to kill him. I don't leave jobs half done.
We don't shoot unarmed prisoners.
How many people died because of him? He brought this on himself. Besides, we have more pressing concerns.
That Quarian's dead if we don't go now.
Take this extra stuff and we better move on. Thank you for scope for working properly.
The Shadow Broker. Where's Fist?
They'll be here. Where's the evidence?
No way. The deal's off.
Okay.
Set me up. I knew I couldn't trust him.
Were you hurt in the fight?
I know how to look after myself. Not that I don't appreciate the help. Who are you?
My name's Shepard. I'm looking for evidence to prove Saren's a traitor.
Then I have a chance to repay you for saving my life. But not here. We need to go somewhere safe.
We could take her to the human embassy. Your ambassador will want to see this anyway.
You're not making my life easy, Shepard. Firefights in the wards, an all-out assault on Korra's den. Do you know how many... Who's this? A Quarian? What are you up to, Shepard?
Making your day, Ambassador. She has information linking Saren to the Geth.
Really? Maybe you better start at the beginning, Miss...
My name is Tali. Tali Zora Naraya.
We don't see many Quarians here. Why did you leave the flotilla?
I was on my pilgrimage. My rite of passage into adulthood.
I've never heard of this before.
It is a tradition among my people. When we reach maturity, we leave the ships of our parents and our people behind. Alone, we search the stars, only returning to the flotilla once we have discovered something of value. In this way, we prove ourselves worthy of adulthood.
What kinds of things do you look for?
It could be resources like food or fuel, or some type of useful technology, or even knowledge that will make life easier on the flotilla. Through our pilgrimage, we prove that we will contribute to the community, rather than being a burden on our limited resources.
Tell us what you found.
During my travels, I began hearing reports of Geth. Since they drove my people into exile, the Geth have never ventured beyond the Veil. I was curious. I tracked a patrol of Geth to an uncharted world. I waited for one to become separated from its unit. Then I disabled it and removed its memory core.
I thought the Geth fried their memory cores when they died. Some kind of defense mechanism.
How did you manage to preserve the memory core?
My people created the Geth. If you're quick, careful, and lucky, small caches of data can sometimes be saved. Most of the core was wiped clean, but I salvaged something from its audio banks.
Eden Prime was a major victory. Beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
That's Saren's voice. This proves he was involved in the attack.
He said Eden Prime brought him one step closer to finding the conduit. Any idea what that means?
The conduit must have something to do with the beacon. Maybe it's some kind of Prothean technology. Like a weapon.
Wait, there's more. Saren wasn't working alone.
Eden Prime was a major victory. Beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
I don't recognize that other voice, the one talking about Reapers.
Are they some kind of new alien species?
According to the Memory Core, the Reapers were a hyper-advanced machine race that existed 50,000 years ago. The Reapers hunted the Protheans to total extinction, and then they vanished. At least, that's what the Geth believe.
Sounds a little far-fetched.
The vision on Eden Prime. I understand it now. I saw the Protheans being wiped out by the Reapers.
The Geth revere the Reapers as gods, the pinnacle of non-organic life. And they believe Saren knows how to bring the Reapers back.
The Council is just going to love this.
The Reapers are a threat to every species in Citadel space. We have to tell them.
No matter what they think about the rest of this, those audio files prove Saren's a traitor.
The Captain's right. We need to present this to the Council right away.
What about her? The Quarian?
My name is Tali. You saw me in the alley, Commander. You know what I can do. Let me come with you.
I thought you were on your pilgrimage.
The pilgrimage proves we are willing to give of ourselves for the greater good. What does it say about me if I turn my back on this? Saren is a danger to the entire galaxy. My pilgrimage can wait.
I'll take all the help I can get.
Thanks. You won't regret this.
Anderson and I will go ahead to get things ready with the Council. Take a few minutes to collect yourself, then meet us in the tower.
Well, I need biotic strength anyways, because it's mostly talking. Lots of talking. Plus, I don't like biotics that much. Stuff for later, probably. Probably do some of that later before I actually start the first major area.
Excuse me, Commander Shepard. Could you spare a moment of your time?
Commander Shepard, my name is Samesh Bhatia. Forgive the intrusion, but I have nowhere else to turn.
It's no trouble. What can I do for you?
My wife was a Marine. She was in the 212 on Eden Prime. I've requested that my wife's body be returned to me for cremation, but the military has refused my request.
Why did they refuse your request? There's got to be some reason.
I don't know. All I know is that they have declared it impossible for my wife to be returned to me.
There's no reason for your wife's body to be held like this. Just wait here.
The man in charge of my case is Mr. Bosker. When I last saw him, he was in the expensive bar over there. Thank you for your time. I just want to give my wife a proper funeral, and the respect she deserves.
Alright, let's see if we can investigate this.
My goodness, you're Commander Shepard. Your activities made for quite a briefing in the Diplomatic Corps. Is there something I can do to assist you?
Yes. A man named Samesh Bhatia is having some trouble claiming his wife's body.
Ah, Mr. Bhatia. A good man in an understandably frustrating position. I wish I could help him. Serviceman Nirali Bhatia died on Eden Prime, as Mr. Bhatia no doubt told you. Her wounds are inconsistent with any type of weapon damage we've seen before. That is why her body is being held.
You think her body might be dangerous or contaminated?
No, Commander. Nirali Bhatia is not dangerous. Her body is, in fact, extremely valuable to the Alliance. The tests we're conducting may lead to better defenses against Geth attacks. Respectfully, Serviceman Bhatia may save more lives in death than she did in life.
I'll tell Mr. Bhatia about this. It might make it easier for him to understand.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Please let me know if you have any other questions.
Let's see if I can do the other alternate solution, because I think that... I don't know. Let's just go back and talk to him.
Hello, Commander. Has any progress been made with Mr. Bosker? Will he return my wife's body?
It's not as simple as I'd hoped. The military needs your wife's body for important tests.
Tests? They're holding my wife's body for tests? My wife served the Alliance faithfully. She gave her life for humanity. And this is how they repay her.
Mr. Bhatia, your wife died defending humanity. We still need her help.
What right does the military have to hold her body? She's already given her life.
She died a hero, Mr. Bhatia. And now she has a chance to save even more lives.
It doesn't matter. She's dead! I just want her to come home. I miss her so much. Let them run their tests. Let my wife save lives so that others are spared the loss I feel today. Goodbye. Thank you for finding me answers.
I like the solution better. I do. Okay, let's see. Maybe I can take care of the Hanar problem as well. I have enough charm. If not, I'll have to wait. I gotta level up, but I don't want to. How many points do I get? I want to save it because I do get Spectre stuff in a moment.
Any progress with that Hanar?
I think you should let the Hanar preach in the Presidium.
The Presidium is a place of culture and respect. It should not be filled with zealots shouting their idiocy. Why should the jellies get special treatment? Every other species understands and obeys the laws.
Oh.
I'll be back.
I don't care what you have to do. Just get rid of that hand.
Okay, I need more charm for that. Definitely focus on getting my charm up so that way I can complete more quests, get more experience.
Please do not disturb the keepers.
Oh, I want to mess with the keepers. Keepers are cool to mess with. I don't know where I'm going. I'm going the wrong way. I need to go this way. To this elevator here. Back to the council.
There's no way the council can ignore us this time. Saren's days as a specter are done.
If the evidence is worth trying to kill me for, I hope it is sufficient to motivate the council.
Musicless area.
Maybe. But I wouldn't believe everything you hear.
That's just it. I'm hearing it everywhere. It's not just.
Come on. Udina's presenting the Quarian's evidence to the council.
Eden Prime was a major victory. Beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
Who's she?
Matriarchs are powerful Asari who have entered the final stage of their lives. Revered for their wisdom and experience, they serve as guides and mentors to my people. Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
I tried to warn you about Saren, and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
Every time humanity asks for help, you ignore us.
Shepard's right. I'm sick of this council and its anti-human bull.
Ambassador, there is another solution. A way to stop Saren that does not require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
You don't have to send a fleet into the Traverse, and the Ambassador gets his human Spectre. Everybody's happy.
Commander Shepard, step forward.
The people looking over, or the species looking over.
It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
Any idea where to find him?
We will forward any relevant files to Ambassador Udina.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now. You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
I thought the Ambassador would be a little more grateful. He didn't even thank you.
Until I find Saren, I haven't done anything. Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
And a level up. Alright, let me see. I have 4 points. Oh wow, I boosted my charm, which is great. Intimidate is a little higher too. 2% discount, 5% eventually. So I'll leave charm alone for a bit. I had the Spectre training, which is nice. Sniper rifles up anymore. I need to actually get tactical armor up. I gotta get decryption. Well, I definitely need decryption up for sure. So I'll eventually run into the problem where I can't decrypt certain things. And getting first aid is kinda nice. And fitness too. Crap, there's so much stuff to get. Probably not gonna pay attention to assault rifles because I can just get away with pistols and sniper rifles in this game. I don't really use assault rifles till the third game. Okay, and that I'm gonna stop for the night because it is already past 5 and I'm getting a little sleepy. So, yep, that's the end of this part. Be back for next part where I will make more progress and kill more stuff, as usual.